to involving or dealing with the abstract, recurrent, universal, formulating general statements or scientific laws.
Would you please use it in a sentence?
For the last 200 years, many have assumed that nomothetic laws of existence can be reached through pure reason.
Is the root nom meaning name?
No.
Nomothetic?
Nomothetic.
What's the language of origin?
Greek.
Greek. Is the root thetis? Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No.
Nomothetic.
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 Should she miss this word?
Is the root nos meaning no?
No.
Prem Trivedi would then have a chance to spell another word and he would become the champion.
Nomothetic.
Should she get the word, Sudheer will be knocked out of the competition.
Is the root theo meaning God?
No.
Nomothetic.
Remember last round.
Is the root myth?
No.
Last round with the word accumbent, Rebecca said she guessed.
Nomothetic. N-O-M-O-T-H-E-T-I-C, nomothetic.
That's correct.
Again, that was just a guess. I didn't know.
Okay.
Rebecca.
How come you're asking
Rebecca
such ridiculous words?
Thanks for the information there, Rebecca Sealfon. We appreciate that. That does eliminate Sudheer Potru, though.
Round
he will finish
15.
Third. And it comes down to Prem Trivedi, Rebecca Sealfon. Last year, these two spellers tied for eighth place in the national championship.
Use a fructuary.
They're now battling for the championship.
Usufructuary.
Usufructuary. Definition, please.
One having the use or enjoyment of something.
Is the root word usufruct?
Yeah, they're connected.
Usufructuary.
Correct.
Use a fructuary. Sentence, please.
Although he leased his farm to a large corporation, Silas remained the usufructuary of the wooded sections.
Use a fructuary. U-S-U F-R U-C-T U-A-R-Y usufructuary.
That is correct.
Now Rebecca spells. She spells it correctly. Obviously, they continue. If she misspells the word, Prem will then be allowed to spell another word to win the title.
any of several alloys of sulfur with silver, copper, or lead having a deep black color.
Niello. Am I hearing this word correctly? Niello.
She appears much more confident than the last round, does she not?
May I please have the definition?
Any of several alloys of sulfur with silver, copper, or lead having a deep black color.
Would you please use it in a sentence?
Katie Kerwin, our analyst, has moved down to the stage.
A design in the silver jewelry box, Philippe filled it with niello.
Who knows when?
Niello. What is the language of origin?
Originally Latin. We took it from Italian.
Niello. Niello. N. I. E. L. L. O. Niello.
Correct.
These two go back and forth. Prem, 11 years old in 7th grade. Rebecca, 13 years old in 8th grade.
Supererogatory.
Prem from Neptune, New Jersey.
Supererogatory. Supererogatory. Definition, please.
Of, relating to, or characterized by performing more than is required by duty or obligation. Superfluous, non-essential.
Is the super part of the word the root meaning extra or more than?
Yes.
And is a root word erogatory?
Meaning?
I don't know.
Doing all I can.
Never mind. Super erogatory. S-U. P-E-R-E-R-O-G-A-T-O-R-Y, supererogatory?
That is correct.
We hear it all the time in sports contests. And we'll probably hear it after this one, too. It's a shame one of these kids has to lose.
Duenna.
What?
Duenna.
Duenna. Am I hearing this word correctly?
Mm-hmm.
May I please have the definition?
An elderly woman serving as governess and companion. Chaperone.
Duenna, are there any alternate pronunciations?
Either duenna or duenna.
Duenna or duenna. Would you please use it in a sentence?
The governor's daughter was never allowed to leave the house without her duenna.
What is the language of origin?
Latin, but we took it from Spanish.
Duenna.
Rebecca's one of three children.
D-U-E-N. N. A. Duenna.
Correct.
And they'll go again. Rebecca's one of three children. Prem.
Round 17.
Doesn't have any siblings. Rebecca has a brother and a sister. Prem's mother's an academic advisor. His father, a telecommunications engineer.
Analemma. Analemma.
Analemma.
This is a graduated scale shaped like a figure eight and showing the sun's declination for each day of the year, usually constituting part of a sundial and often shown on globes.
These two spellers have more in common than just spelling.
Analemma. Can I have a sentence?
Katrina consulted the sun's analemma to calculate the correct time.
Just the origin, please.
Greek.
They both enjoy playing the
analemma.
Game of chess.
Analemma.
They play chess the way they spell. The computer may be in trouble, huh?
It's a noun.
Yes.
Wait, can I have the definition again, please?
It's a graduated scale shaped like a figure eight and showing the sun's declination for each day of the year.
Analemma. A-N-N-A-L-E-M-M-A, analemma.
Prem has missed a word. That doesn't mean he's out of it. Rebecca Sealfon.
Analemma is A-N-A-L-E-M-M-A.
Rebecca must now spell this word and a following word correctly to win the championship. If she doesn't, Prem Trivedi's back in the competition. They've been spelling 7 hours and 23 minutes today.
Dulcinea.
Dulcinea.
Nia.
No.
Dulcinea.
Dulcinea.
Dulcinea. Dulcinea.
Dulcinea. May I please have the definition?
It's a word that means a mistress or sweetheart.
Dulcinea. Would you please use it in a sentence?
Confined to barracks, the soldier spent the afternoon playing cards and telling lies about how rich and beautiful. The soldiers spent the afternoon playing cards and telling lies about how rich and beautiful each one's Dulcinea was.
Dulcinea or Dulcinea? I can't hear.
Nia. Dulcinea.
Nia. What's the language of origin?
Latin, but eventually this meaning came from a Spanish name, the name of a character in a novel.
Dulcinea. Is the word dulce meaning sweet?
Yes.
Dulcinea.
Rebecca Dulcinea. From Brooklyn, New York. Homeschooled.
Yes, say it again, Rebecca, please.
Dulcinea. Nia.
While her mother's a homeschool teacher, her father's a neurologist and a neurobiologist.
D. Dulcinea. D. U-L-C-E, Dulcinea or Dulcinea? Dulcinea.
Dulcinea is D-U-L-C-I-N-E-A.
So for the first time, these two have missed the word, and they're competing.
Round 18.
Rebecca's folks, Celia and Stuart.
Holophytic. Holophytic.
Holophytic.
obtaining food after the manner of a green plant. Holophytic, holophytic.
Holophytic?
Can I have that in a sentence, please?
Most holophytic creatures use photosynthesis to process their food.
One of two remaining spellers in the 70th annual Scripps Howard National Spelling Bee.
Holophytic.
The other, Rebecca Sealfon from Brooklyn, New York. 13 in 8th grade. Prem, 11 years old in 7th grade.
What's the origin?
Greek.
Going on 7.5 hours of spelling today. There was an hour break for lunch.
Is this an adjective?
Yes.
The competition began Wednesday morning.
Holophytic. H O L O P H Y T I C. Holophytic.
That is correct.
Prem Trivedi is back. Got his game together. Now the pressure shifts to Rebecca Sealfon.
Sufflaminate.
Sufflaminate.
Sufflaminate is a verb that means to obstruct or impede.
Sufflaminate. Would you please use it in a sentence?
Because Tim said that not having a computer would sufflaminate his progress, his parents gave in and bought him one.
What is the language of origin?
Latin.
And are there any alternate pronunciations?
Dr. Alex Cameron, the pronouncer here for 17 years. He's pronounced every word in this competition this
year. Sufflaminate.
Yesterday and today. And when she goes to cover
her mouth. Sufflaminate, am I hearing it correctly?
She's ready to spell.
S. U. F. F. L. A. M. I. N. A. T. E. Sufflaminate.
That's correct.
And they continue to go at it. Prem Trivedi, Rebecca Sealfon, the parents of Rebecca, Celia
Round
to the left.
Round 19.
The doctor, Dr. Stewart Sealfon to the right.
Foudroyant.
Foudroyant. Is it French?
Yes, originally Latin. We took it from French. It means thundering or dazzling.
Foudroyant?
Foudroyant.
Foudroyant. Can I have that in a sentence?
Norbert gazed in awe at the foudroyant fireworks display.
Outside of spelling, Prem likes archaeology, reading, swimming, as I mentioned earlier, chess.
It's a part of speech.
This is an adjective.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Very tiny variation. I don't think it will help. Foudroyant, foudroyant.
Foudroyant. F-O-U-D-R-O-Y-A-N-T. Foudroyant.
That's correct.
Unlike Rebecca, who was offered a couple of times this afternoon that she was just guessing on a word, we don't know with Prem, he won't say.
Deliquesce.
Look would suggest
Does
such.
Does this mean tend to melt away?
Become soft or liquid with age.
Deliquesce. Would you please use it in a sentence?
After a couple of weeks in the refrigerator, celery begins to deliquesce.
Deliquesce. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No, just one.
Deliquesce. What language does this word come from?
Latin.
Deliquesce, is that the word? Deliquesce. D. E. L. I. Q. U. E. S. C. E. Deliquesce.
That's correct.
Rebecca Sealfon. Very familiar. You see her whole family there, her brother and sister and her parents.
Round 20.
Into the 20th round now.
Phil Helene, an admirer or supporter of Greece or of the Greeks, is a Phil Helene.
Phil Helene.
A year ago, this competition went 13 rounds.
Yes.
Phil Helene.
We are now into round 20.
Can I have a sentence, please?
After one trip to the museum, Lydia became an instant Phil Helene.
Phil Helene. Can I have a definition one more time, please?
An admirer or supporter of Greece or of the Greeks.
So it's a noun?
Correct.
Philhellene, P-H-I-L-H-E-L-L-E-N-E, Philhellene?
That's correct.
Piece the word together and spells it correctly. Now, Rebecca Sealfon. Waiting for her word.
Bourgade.
Bourgade.
Bourgade is an unfortified town of scattered dwellings.
Bourgade.
Would you, let's check the ending one more time. Would you say that?
Bourgade. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No, just the one.
Bourgade.
Beck likes reading fiction, nonfiction, writing stories. Playing the piano, working with computers.
The advancing army took over the Bourgade without any resistance from its inhabitants.
What's the language of origin?
It was originally Latin, and after a while, we took it from French.
Bourgade. B. This was not P, this was B. O. Bourgade. U. R. G. A. D. E. Bourgade.
That's correct.
And it won't end. Now there's Prem's father to the left of your screen.
Round 21.
Capturing this on videotape.
Griffonage.
Griffonage. Can I have a definition?
Griffonage is careless handwriting, crude or illegible scrawl.
What's the origin?
French.
The look on Prem's face.
Any alternate pronunciations?
No.
Griffonage. Can I have a sentence?
The pharmacist assured us that what looked like griffonage were simply Latin abbreviations.
Griffonage. G-R I F F O N A G E Griffonage.
That's correct.
There's a proud father. Maybe a little shaky when they go to look at it on the television. You get that way when you get excited.
Anglophilia.
Anglophilia, does this mean excessive love for England?
Yes.
Is the root Anglo meaning English, as in Anglo-Saxon, you know?
My guess is she's familiar with the word.
Okay. Yes?
Is the root file meaning love?
Rebecca Sealfon, Prem Trivedi, going head-to-head. It is match competition now. They've been spelling against one another for the last 40 minutes.
There's a connection.
A little more than 2.5 hours ago, we had 35
spellers on
the stage.
Anglophilia, am I hearing this word correctly? Are there any alternate pronunciations?
40 minutes ago, Sudheer
Potru, would you please use it in a sentence?
From Detroit, Michigan, was eliminated.
After one trip abroad, Alice was seized by Anglophilia and moved to London.
Brooklyn, New York.
Anglophilia.
Prem Trivedi from Neptune, New Jersey.
A N G L O P H I L I A Anglophilia.
That's correct.
And so it goes. We'll now go into round 22.
Round 22.
All right. Thanks for the confirmation, Mary. Mary Brooks, one of the chief judge
Cortile.
Here.
Cortile. Cortile.
Cortile?
Yes, it's an Italian word, originally Latin, an Italian word that means an open courtyard enclosed by the walls of a building or buildings.
What was the origin again?
First Latin, and then we took it from Italian.
Say it again, please.
Cortile, cortile.
Any alternate pronunciations?
No.
Cortile, cortile, cortile.
Cortile.
Cortile. Any alternate definitions?
No.
Cortile. Cortile. So definition again?
An open courtyard enclosed by the walls of a building or buildings.
Cortile. It's a noun? It's a noun?
Yes.
Cortile. C-O-R-T-I-L-E. I-L-L-E, Cortile.
Cortile is C-O-R-T-I-L-E.
Gets a well-deserved round of applause. If you've been with us, you know how it goes now. Rebecca would have to spell this word and a following word to win the national championship.
Coterie.
Coterie.
They're back.
Does this mean a click?
Yes.
C. O.
I'm wanting to end this.
T. E. R. I. E. Coterie.
That's correct.
Now that's a departure from Rebecca Sealfon's routine. She jumped in and spelled a word. The family likes that. That was the seventh round.
Rebecca is the only contestant
between those two spellers.
End of round 22. She will now be given the next word on the pronouncer's list, and if she succeeds in correctly spelling this word, she will be declared the champion.
Her mother, Celia, looks more nervous than Rebecca. 13-year-old bundle of nerves and energy.
Euonym. Is what you meaning good?
Yes.
Is what on a meaning name?
Yes.
Euonym!
She still has to spell it.
E! Yeah! Ow! N! Y! M U M!
That's correct.
Rebecca Sealfon. Oh. How about
Scripps
Rebecca Sealfon?
To present the 1997 National Spelling Bee Champion Katie representing Kerwin's. The New York Daily News, Rebecca Sealfon.
Yay!
I think she's happy. Katie Kerwin is trying to make her way up there to talk with her. Through it all, and she had a great competitor in Prem Trivedi. Prem can be back next year. He's only 11. He's a seventh grader. Rebecca was an eighth grader, 13 years old. She's the winner of this 70th annual National Scripps Hour National Spelling Bee. Now let's go to Katie on the floor with Rebecca Sealfon.
Rebecca.
What?
You're the very first homeschooler ever to win the National Spelling Bee. Yes. What do you think about that? How did you pull that off?
Well, first of all, I knew this year was my last year, and I studied harder than usual. I've only been here twice, and I was especially determined after I got out on erythema last year.
So, Rebecca, you told us earlier that you actually hate being on stage and spelling. Have you changed your mind about that now?
No. There shouldn't have a bee. Even though I want it.
What's that? You really think there shouldn't be a bee?
Yes, because many children are in grief because they lose. And everyone gets nervous when, yeah.
But you got nervous and you triumphed and you made it through the nerves and you won.
I was incredibly lucky. I could have gotten out any round.
Okay, so what was your toughest word of the whole competition?
I don't remember. The nomothetical, I think. Maybe dulcimia.
All right, well, congratulations to the 1997 National Spelling Bee Champion.
Now we have some questions. Who's first? Rebecca, they want to know about...
Five who started from the 245 who started Wednesday morning to Rebecca Sealfon. It has been a fascinating competition. Congratulations to the runner-up, Prem Trivedi. He can be back next year. And Sudheer Potru, who finished third. This was an outstanding competition. If it gets any better, maybe next year. Thanks for joining us.